the Bob Doyle Show.
It's the Bob Doyle Show.
I don't know why it... Hey! I don't know why it needed to be easier then. Time to readjust that camera angle a little bit. Hi, it's me with some swag. Yeah. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you know what time it is because they're singing that song. It's the Bob Doyle Show, and it's episode number 37. That means it is the 37th. Today marks the 37th anniversary in years. 37th anniversary of me not having any idea that one day I would be saying this sentence. So I think that deserves applause too. Okay, so you know what we have to do. I gotta go find you. And is that me? No. Is that me? No. Is that me? No. Is that me? No. There's me. And then we go over here. And that's not gonna work. So I'm trying to figure out. Now see, it happens differently every time. Where I can sometimes see your comments, sometimes not, but I have to know. So here's the thing we have to do. We have to share this broadcast, but I wanted to show you that we're going to do this together. Hold on just a second. Now, here's the broadcast, a little to me right here. Here's what you all need to do. Now, I can't see you yet. I don't know who's here. Maybe no one's here. I'm going to share. I'm going to click on share. I'm going to say write post, and I'm going to say go now, and I'll change it later to be better, of course, and oh, shoot, I did the same thing as I did last time. I posted it to this very same show. That's goofy. I need to post it to my timeline. You all need to post it to your timeline, too. So, let's try this again. Go now. Don't you love the professionalism of this? If I had an admin person... All right, so now I don't know what I'm looking at here. I'm looking at a delay. Now, right here, here's where comments should be. But it's not working, and I don't know why. So but I can get it work because I have been able to. Oh, we've got a comment, but I'm not seeing it yet. All right, you guys, just bear with me. This is a system. It's a new system, which isn't working very well. But I'm going to figure it out anyway. All right, so now we have to. Robert Hicks is in the house laughing at me right now. He's laughing at me for good reason. Let's see if this works. Nope, but in a minute it will. You watch. And Bob, and go and stop. Now we have, ladies and gentlemen, comments. Let's hear the applause again. Now we're where we should be. Welcome, everybody. Now, where? Speaking of everybody, where the heck are you? Now, this is the second time in a row I have broadcast here on the Bob Doyle Show page. That's, you need to know now that that's what we do. We don't broadcast to the timeline anymore. We can look over at my timeline if you want. I shouldn't mess with it. I just got this working correctly. But if you're watching this show on my timeline, stop it. And now I also know that I have two posts here on this page. I need to delete the extra one. I'm going to do that over here where you can't see me. So let's talk about something. Did everyone have a wonderful week? Where can you get one of those $25 coffee mugs? Well, oddly enough, I can show you right now. It is, whoops, come on, Mousy, where are you? You got to go to the Bob Doyle Show store. Hey, what happened there? No. Hey, whoa, relax. You got to go to the bobdoyleshow.com/store, ladies and gentlemen. You see how we just jumped right into the commercials? This show is sponsored by the Bob Doyle Show swag store. Where are you all? I don't even have, now, I think just Robert left the room. And now we don't have Dawn. We don't have any of our regulars. Ladies and gentlemen, it is Friday, I believe. We have an agreement. We have an agreement that everybody shows up here on Fridays to do the show and then says hello, but you have to come to the Bob Doyle Show fan page. Today is too good of a show to waste. All right, so you know what? You're sharing on your Facebook pages. You are an officer and a gentleman. So now let me go and delete this extra. You can watch me do it. Now see, here's how the show works. For those of you who are scared about of live broadcasting because of this type of thing happening, don't sweat it. Just share your spiral into the abyss. Now, see, this is the one I need to get rid of because this is not the one that anyone's watching or that I don't want them to. Delete from page. Delete. You see what I did there? And now we have this one. This is our show. All right? This is the one that we're supposed to be looking at. Now, if we go to my timeline, let's see what's happening over here. There it is. Nobody's watching over here, which is good. But you know what I'm going to do? Oh, I can't. I can't edit it right now. Or maybe I can. I just can't see the... can't get over far enough. Come on. There we go. I'm going to edit this description. See, this is... You're learning. I'm giving you a tutorial, a Facebook Broadcast Live tutorial. That is, if you have... Oh, and now we're going to infinity. That's always fun. If you're watching this show on my timeline, what's up with that? We broadcast live now on the Bob Doyle Show fan page. Come on and join us over there so we can see your face-ish. There. Beautiful. That is poetry. Now, why won't it save? Come on now. There we go. Save. All right. Now we don't have to worry about all that anymore. Let's go back over here to, I don't even know what we're looking at. Comments, and it's just Robert Hicks. Did you figure out how to... Jory's here. Jory, will you please say hello so I don't feel like it's just Rob hanging out in this room? And where, you know, I don't know. What do I have to do? I think I'm going to have to send $5 bills out to everybody and say, look, if I have to bribe you to go to the right place on the Bob Doyle Show, well, then that's what I'll do. I'm not going to do that, by the way. But I sure would appreciate it if more people were in this room. I even said, if you look at my description, it says something about if you're even contemplating not watching the show today, you need to rethink that. There's way too much happening. Now, look, I said I was going to start with Apptacular, and I totally was. But now I'm not, because I had another idea. But I am sharing an Apptacular today for those of you VR heads out there who appreciate early adoption. What I'm going to show you is something that it's really early in the technology. I know it's going to get better. Belinda! Cody! Hey, Cody! Now, we've got Belinda and Cody. Now the people are coming in. Good thing I didn't, you know, spill any beans. First of all, beans. Ooh, we've discussed that a couple of shows ago. Hello, Belinda. Thanks for saying hey. Did we really cover the store enough? I don't know if we did. I don't know if you're really clear on how to get one of these mugs. Let's go back. This is what the store looks like. And this, you'll see, this mug right here is very similar. Look at that. It's the same mug. Well, all right. Yes, we discussed beans. But then there's the t-shirt, which I'm also wearing. What? I thought I had long ago. Look at that. My head's getting cut off. As long as I'm sharing every little aspect of my show with you today, I'm going to fix this too. Watch. I'm going to fix this so that my head doesn't get cut off. Well, I said I was going to, but now it looks like it shouldn't be getting cut off. So I don't know what's going on. Hey, you don't even see what's happening. Here. Burp, there. Hey, I got really big all of a sudden. Well, if you love the t-shirt, why aren't you sending me pictures of you wearing one, Belinda? That's the deal. I have these up here so that people will buy them for only $34. That is that's such a deal. Well, the top of my head was getting cut off a little bit. It was. I wouldn't make that up. Look, here's the deal. I know there's people with cheaper t-shirts that would do this for me, so... If you know them, let's get this done. We all know the concept, right? Bob Doyle swag. Coffee mugs, t-shirts, that type of thing. But look, $34 for a freaking... you're an Uber fan if you do it, and that's great. We want Uber fans. Or Lyft fans. Do you see what I did there? Am I distorted? Seems like I'm distorted. So yesterday... Was it yesterday? Yes, yesterday, I was the guest. Hold on. Just everybody just relax, because first of all, if you're not sitting down, you'd better sit down. Don't say I didn't warn you. You're going to share on your page, but you're going to run. Cody, all right. Well, thanks for sharing anyway. Now look, I know you're going to think I'm lying, because how could I possibly score something like this? You're going to think I'm making it up. But online proof, Kobe's here. Jeff Adams Show. That's right, the Jeff Adams Show. I was the guest yesterday. Don't pretend like you don't know. Jennifer Quinn, I told you to sit down. Now see, now you're probably laid out on the floor because I said something you already know. But it's the way I said it, right? It's the way I just put those words together in a way that, even though you knew I was on Jeff Adams' show yesterday, did you? You should. You're part of that group. I'm going to be on Jenny Q's show one of these days. November, did we say? Or December? Or 2019? Something. She's very booked. Very popular. Folks, the Bob Doyle Show, just so you know, I've been telling you this since the beginning. I don't know if you believe me or not, but you should believe, because I'm not a liar. The Bob Doyle Show is about to explode, and not in a bad, bloody, gross, intestine spewing everywhere way, because that is not my style. Unless I'm playing a video game, then bring it on. We talked about that. Like, I can't, I just happen to, oh, I'm distorted. Oh, no. Am I still distorted? I turned down my volume a little. JoJo? Who's JoJo? Who is JoJo? Because I don't see anybody in this house except for you guys. I'm going to wait. You know what? I'm not going to do anything until I got 800 people in here. Ooh, that's not going to happen. Today. But anyway, over the course of the next couple of months, the Bob Doyle is going to be appearing on all these little shows. And before you know it, we're not even going to be able to get in this room. We're going to have to get a bigger arena. Because the 80,000 person capacity that this arena has is going to be overflowing. Kenneth, you, I believe, are new to this program. In that case, we're going to give you some applause because you deserve it. Or, everyone just please. Or, you've been here before but you haven't said anything. Or, I completely missed it. No, I don't know who JoJo Keys, well, Joe. Well, hi, Joe, it's nice to meet you, but I know now, don't I? My guess is, you probably, since they called out to you, that you know Rob and Jeff and all those guys. Okay. Yeah, a bigger arena, right, to hold 90, 100, 110,000 people. Well, Kenneth, it is great to have you here. Please take your seat in the front row where we have reserved space for all the new people, where so they can get a nice, close look at my so they know exactly what I look like. By the way, the sausage note, check it out. Still a little mark. If you weren't here last week, then you don't know what I'm talking about with the sausage nose. But if you weren't here last week, you must have been ill. So just email me your doctor's note and everything will be fine. We're all allowed two unexcused absences. So, but a doctor's note counts as an excused absence as long as it's not obviously forged. I mean, if I look at it and I go, Kobe, this is your handwriting, it's obvious. Allison, you're new. So you are Allison, ladies and gentlemen, she's new. Now we're assuming that she's new to this show. But it could be that she's new to the planet. We don't know, because she didn't specify. Oh, Allison, I have to admit it. I spied on you a little yesterday, because you showed up somewhere, and here's what we love about Allison. I wish I could go there right now. I guess I could. Allison, do you care if I go to your profile and show people your pictures? You got them on Facebook. I mean, people can see them anyway. I mean, I don't think we're Facebook friends. Anybody in this room could follow you and see what I was going to show you. You've been around here many times? Well, I'm glad. And I'll tell you, I have to. Hold on. I'm just going to sneak over here, and I'm going to assume that she says it's okay. Because I have to show you something about Allison. And let's see. If I can get there. Allison Crow. There she is. Now, I'm not showing you yet. She said, go for it. Awesome. All right. So now we're going to, let's pop over here to Allison's page. Now, what do we notice right away? All right. Let's dig a little deeper. What do we see right away? Now, hold on. We're going to keep going. Look, ladies and gentlemen, are you kidding me with this? Now, this picture was taken October, so at least last year. I can't see the freaking year. But, folks, do you see why I am an Allison Crow fan right away? Anyone? Can anyone see the connection? Look, let's look at your mugs again. Now, are we making the connection now? All right, so ladies and gentlemen, Allison's been a bobblehead since before she even knew what it was. Now that is amazing, and I think deserves another round of applause. Allison, you got the big applause. Deborah Lee Merchant in the house also, who we met on the show last week. We didn't meet her. I met her before that. But you all met her on the show last week. And now we know, I think, if we listen, I think we talked about it, that I'll be on Deborah Lee's show. That's right, Kobe. Kobe just came right out and said it. It's obvious that Allison likes to open her mouth just like me. And I made her day, or somebody did. Something made her day. Her day has been made. And that is awesome. Thank you for the thumbs up, whoever's doing it. Yesterday on the Law of Attraction broadcast, holy moly, ravioli. We had hearts and... Hi, Charlotte. Ladies and gentlemen, let's please welcome Charlotte in the house. You'll see that she... Today is Fan Appreciation Day. There's Charlotte holding the Bob Doyle Show coffee mug like a champ. If you send me pictures of you doing this, I'm going to make you a star. Believe me. Look, I know we've got a modest crowd right now, but again, when this all goes to syndication and when the Bob Doyle Show's a thing and people are like, they're like closing the internet down, trying to find archives of the show, all of you people who've been here from the beginning, you're going to be a superstar. Wait a minute, Charlotte was on the show even back then? Allison and Deborah and Kobe? I don't know where Sharon is today, and I don't know where, you know, there's some regulars who have gone away. They haven't shown up. Thank you, Allison, for the campaign, for the hearts and thumbs up. Thank you very much. That's the nicest thing that anyone's ever done for me. Now, how many people know what that's from? Now, I say that to identify my demographic. Does anybody know what that's from? Someone's got to know. Someone's got to know what that song is from, and I'm not moving on until somebody tells me. Because you see, I've forgotten and I need to know. All right, that's not true. I haven't forgotten. Scrooge the movie, Jeff Adams. See, I'm telling you. So what I learned about Jeff Adams yesterday is that we're the same person. Very similar backgrounds, very similar things that we're passionate about, and clearly have a lot to talk about. And Jeff Adams is the first to nail Scrooge the movie, the musical, starring, come on, obviously you know that. That's a silly test, but I still want to see if he'll type it. Anybody else know that besides Jeff? Bill Murray, oh. I wish I had a sound effect of wah, 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 wah. Like if I had my last week's Apptacular app, the pocket sitcom, I could give you the old wah, wah, wah. Because that, my friends, is Scrooged. A more recent remake of the Scrooge Christmas Carol story, starring Bill Murray and Bobcat Goldthwait and a cast of others. but that is not the movie I'm talking about. Albert Finney is, in fact, the correct answer. Let's hear it again for Jeff Adams. Jeff Adams. However, I will say, Kenneth, that I really enjoyed the Bill Murray version as well. In fact, I'd have to say that Scrooge, the musical that we're talking about, with Thank You Very Much in it, and a host of other wonderful songs that you really... I'm not a musical guy. I really ask the woman I live with who does musical stuff all the times. All the time. Not a big musical fan. I'm really not. I mean, I could go the rest of my life and not watch The Sound of Music. Bye, Deborah Lee. Got to work out. You don't think this show is like a workout? To work out for me, I work up a sweat. I'm drinking this coffee way too fast. Who's Leanne? Wait a minute. What did I miss? I think I'm not seeing some people. Oh, there she is. Like, boy, perfect timing. Hi, Leanne Isaacson, also new to the show. We are doing a lot of applause today. Slowly but surely getting people over here into the right zone of the internet. To the Bob Doyle Show fan page. Do we call it fan pages anymore? It's my, I don't know, Rob calls it something else. Professional page? Ironic, since this is not, as such, at this time, a professional endeavor. But we hope to change that sometime within the next 7.5 minutes. Okay, not really. You know, we were talking yesterday on Jeff Adams' show about audience and getting, you know, bigger groups of people in and what works and what doesn't and all of that. And we pretty much decided, Jeff, didn't we, that being a cute blonde female is a good way to at least start to get an audience, right? So, fun is the new work. That's right, Allison Crow. Oh, I see. Someone has to work out. Yeah, but if you're referring to Deborah Lee Merchant's workout, Leanne will be the LinkedIn lady of Facebook Live. I know nothing about LinkedIn. I have a lot of connections, and I update my profile from time to time. Know how to use it? No. Don't know the difference between a status update and a post? Absolutely do not know. I don't know. Leanne, you have to help me. Can LinkedIn help me leverage this show? Can LinkedIn get more people in this room? Or...
do I just have to resort to being a cute blonde?
Hi, it's me, Bob Doyle. Today, from now on, we will do the show like this.
All right, that voice is a little high. We'll just go with this. So let's see how my viewership goes up now. We'll do the whole cute blonde thing for a while. Hi, everybody, it's me. It's Bobby Doyle. And Bobby wants as many listeners as she can possibly get. So let's just tell the whole internet that the Bob Doyle Show is now all about being cute. It's just about being cute and giggly. Does this work? Do I need to give a tutorial on makeup application? I'm doing makeup over here, over there. I'm doing makeup everywhere. Okay. All right. Is this working? Says it's working. Jeff says it's working. I don't see any. I get it, Robert Hicks. I'm showing Bob's. If you're hip on the whole Periscope show, Bopsy, I got Helen's attention now. So if I've got Helen's attention, it's just a matter of time before I get the entire other internet. Wait a minute. Okay, I'm looking at the numbers. This is me looking up at the numbers. So the numbers went up. So this is it. So from now on, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Bob Doyle Show as... Tonto Aphrodite, that's my name. You can see it right there on the sign. Hello, I'm Tonto Aphrodite. I'm really, really mighty. And I'm super, super good at getting viewers to my show. Kind of like Melanie Bundaku, just walk in the room and can also fill a room, cause she's an attractive female just like me, only not so blonde. Okay, is it working? Do I have 1,000 people in here yet? Nope, nope, nope. Gotta keep going. Gotta keep going. Well, let's just move on to a real topic. Let's just do the show and not just talk about the fact that, well, that I should be getting thousands and thousands of viewers because we are testing the theory that people like me get more viewers. So, I was on a plane the other day, of course, because I travel and I can't get on a plane and travel without telling you all about it. Okay, someone's going to go get a couple and they'll be right back. Helen, thank you. So, I was on a plane and have you noticed? Did you ever notice? What's the deal with airplane? Okay, you know how sometimes the pilots come on and they give you an announcement and it's super loud, like way too loud? Like, why is he so loud? Why is he yelling into the thing?
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to do something very loud for you right now and tell you things you don't need to know. In fact, I'm going to reserve my high volume conversations for things you absolutely do not need to know. However, when something is important, like bad weather,
I will be this far away from the microphone, and you will not be able to understand anything I say, even if you take off your headphones.
Am I right, ladies and gentlemen? Am I right? Does that happen?
Well, I'm Bob. I'm just the new improved bring in more viewers, Bob. And it's worked, by the way. Viewership has gone up by 30-something percent since I changed who I am. So from now on, it's the Tonto Aphrodite Show. It's the Tonto Show. It's the Tonto Show. Does that work? Well, all I can do is what I'm doing. Pinky's here. Hi, Pinky. Yes, Leanne, you're blonde. That's all you have to do. It's been proven scientifically on this show right here. It's the Bob Doyle live streaming laboratory listener magnetization. Wait a minute. Something's gone. Nope, we're spiraling into the abyss. Oh, Robert. Caitlin, Bob, I get it. Everyone else get it?
All right, we're back, ladies and gentlemen, with the Bob Doyle Show. Thank you very much. It was working for a while there, but then, Pinky, you're right. That would be a very costly move. I'd have to get new mugs, new shirts, Tonto Aphrodite. That would wrap all the way around the mug. That would never work. So, sorry, ladies and gentlemen. We're back to the Bob Doyle Show, and that's what it is. The Bob Doyle Show from now on. But every now and then, who knows, maybe we will have a little bit of Tonto Aphrodite. Oh, Pinky and Melanie, they're crying. This show's about happiness, and here I've made everyone sad. All right, not everybody's sad. Just two ladies are sad. That's right, this is the Bob Doyle Show. Guaranteed to make two ladies sad. I know you're not crying tears of sadness. You're laughing so hard that you can't possibly contain the tears. They're shooting out. In fact, I hope you have the new I hope you have the new iPhone 7, which is water resistant, so that those tears that are saturating your phone, the tears of laughter as we've established, are not harming it in any way. In fact, you cry a meter of tears and hold that phone in that meter of tears for 30 minutes. And it'll be okay. That's the beauty. I wouldn't know. You know what I found out today? This was not on my docket. This is not on my list. This is not an Evernote note that I'm about to say. This is Dave Werba. It's not Dave Werba, but I just see that Robert is saying. So Dave, somehow Robert knows who's here long before I do. Yes, Dawn. Let's let everyone see that Dawn admitted she's late. Says so right here. We have it in writing. Do you have a note? Now, we already discussed that we have two unexcused absences. Now, tardy, we have a different policy. We're a little more lenient on the tardiness because, you know, you got to do your life. And we've been switching over to doing the show on Bob Doyle Show. So, you know, a lot of people end up in the old classroom and they're looking around going, you know, if the professor doesn't show up in 10 minutes, I think we can leave. What is it? No, I heard it was 15 minutes. Well, it depends on how long the professor's been here. What do you mean? Well, you know, if he's tenured, then you have to wait 20 minutes. But if he's like a student teacher, 5 minutes. And if they come in smelling like alcohol, you can just leave. You have a note. Well, okay, Dawn. Nadine, thank you for being on time. You were a little late chiming in, I think. But unless I missed it, which I could have. When Tonto was in charge. Now, see, he did it again. Robert saying hey to Jay, who hasn't even shown up. Robert, how do you know who's in here when I don't? I believe this is my show. It says so on this mug and on this shirt. It doesn't say the Robert Hicks show. The Robert Hicks psychic I know who's coming into the room before they even come into the room show. Jay is here. Hello, Jay. All right, so there's a lot of new people today, and I am just beside myself, which I technically could actually do. I could put myself beside myself right now. That'd be weird, but I didn't think about it. So anyway, what I was saying, so this is an iPhone 6 Plus. And almost as soon as I got, anybody else have a iPhone 6 Plus? Leanne, why are you still awake? Do you know what time it is where you are? Because I sure don't. Although you did say, someone said South Australia or something. Maybe that was you, I don't know. Anyway, so iPhone 6 Plus, you know, the big one. And almost since the beginning, it's like I'll touch the screen and it won't respond. Like the screen's dead, it's not seeing. And so I have to turn it off and turn it back on all the way off, but just turn off the screen, turn it back on, and then it works. And I thought, well, that's just me. I'll get around to it. I'll go to the Apple store eventually and get it traded out. Well, I come to find out today that this is pretty much number one ongoing issue that Apple has with these phones. They get calls on it all the time. In fact, the article I read this morning said it used to be that that's like the biggest thing they get, and now it's pretty much like that's all they get. And here's the thing, friends. Are we friends? I'd like to think we're friends, especially after all this time. I mean, even if you're new, we've spent a half an hour together, and I think that's pretty much, I think spending a half an hour with someone automatically makes them your friend. Unless you're on a plane, in which case a half an hour with someone, you never want to see them again. Yes, the Tribe does bring the game. So, ladies and gentlemen, again, for Robert Hicks and Tribe, for bringing on the new people, who hopefully will stay with me week after week after week, along with me and Tonto. Tonto Aphrodite. All right. Ads coming to Facebook Live. Is that a fact? Well, that's good. Do we get to see any revenue from that? Or is Facebook going to make all the money? If we start doing ads as part of the Facebook Live broadcast, do we get a piece of that? Because that'd be nice. I just have to make sure I sell really expensive stuff with the number of groups, the number of people I have. Helen, you're new. Welcome. You know what we do for new people? We welcome them. Sorry, that's unfortunate. Wow, well, Helen, we've got two Helens in the group. Statistically, with the number of people we have in here, the fact that we have two Helens in the room, that's, I think we've got a miracle, ladies and gentlemen, a statistical mirror. Mirror? I don't know where that came from. Miracle. Anyway, the whole thing with the thing, that's like, they know about this problem, and they've, Apple, I mean, and they've never commented on it. They don't acknowledge it. And even if you have bought the, I don't know why I'm dissing Apple right now. Is that really in my best interests? You were here first. Okay, Helen, then you win the prize, which whatever prize, I don't really have a prize for you right now. unless you'd like an old network cable that I happen to find. Two disappointed ladies, two Helens, what's next is right. This is the miracle program. Anyway, they even acknowledge that it's a problem and it's their biggest problem. And some speculation is they don't have a fix for it, so they're not going to acknowledge it. Even if you have Apple Care Plus, they still charge you for it. It's not good, ladies and gentlemen. This is not something that I expect from our good friends at Apple. Not acknowledging a problem that clearly almost everybody's having, charging us for a fix. Some have speculated that they fixed the problem on the 6S Plus, the 6S Plus, but us S Pluses people, you know, the people who said, Apple, we love you so much, we trust you, we're jumping on right now, we're going to get that product of yours because we know you would never, ever, ever, ever knowingly send out some piece of crap because you're Apple. I'll bet you if Steve Jobs was around and he knew about this, we'd all be having new phones. He'd come out and he'd go, I don't do a Steve Jobs imitation. But if I did, he'd be saying something like, you know, we acknowledge our mistakes, we're committed to customer satisfaction, we understand the trust you've put in our company, we understand that Apple people are loyal people. They believe in their products. They believe in the quality. Apple, the name Apple means something to them. And if they're going to spend $800 on a phone, they deserve to have it work correctly. And if we have a defect, we will take a responsibility for that. Because you know what? We'll make the money back. It ain't a problem. But they did not do that because Steve is not around. Hi, Paul. Hey, Paul. We got two people saying, hey, Paul, and I don't see a Paul in the room. Again, I don't understand this magic, this voodoo, this Rob Hicks voodoo. Sorry, you guys can't see the comments. That was my bad. My bad. I got all on my iPhone rant and accidentally didn't acknowledge you. But I didn't mean to not acknowledge you. Anyway, speaking of Apple, the bad. Let me throw a VR thing at you. And this is really super quick. And it's really, I'm just going to touch on this. So Tim Cook is the CEO over there. He's the a few weeks ago, well, actually for a long time, I've been saying in terms of virtual reality, I think I may have to just go, I don't know what I'm going to do. I shouldn't have started this topic, but I did. So it's too late now. I have to finish it. I got to commit. But I've always said that VR, while I love it, obviously, and it's the direction my company is going into, I share VR stuff with you all the time. I'm going to the Apptacular thing kind of VR-ish today, so stick around for that, ladies and gentlemen. Whether you have an Android phone or an iPhone, whether or not the touch screen works or not, you'll enjoy this one if you're willing to be an early adopter. And know that the technology that I'm going to share with you today will probably get better. Just hang in there. Sarah is here. Sarah, you're a little late too. The show starts at noon. I'm teasing. Well, I'm not. It does start at noon. And there's no excuse for tardiness. But except that you're Sarah Jane. See, here's the thing. I should say, those of you who join the Bob Doyle Show fan club arena, you're excused from being tardy. That's right. You don't need any notes. You can be tardy and absentee. You get five if you join the fan club arena. Bob, how do we do that? Well, on this page that you're on right now, the Bob Doyle Show page. Hello, E.B. Toddy. That is so fun to say. I just want to say it over and over. If I had a uke right now, but they're all on the wall over there. The E.B. Toddy, I'm telling you, E.B. Toddy, you gotta be a regular, and I promise you, next time I show up on this show, I will have an E.B. Toddy song waiting pour vu. It won't be waiting. I'll make it up on the fly like I always do. Like I do this whole show. Did you think I rehearsed this? Does it seem rehearsed? Probably seems rehearsed. Probably looking and going, man, he must work from Friday afternoon the previous week with practicing the smoothness, and his fake technical problems. Like a hot toddy, I hear you. I bet you've been saying that your whole life, I'm guessing. See Aphrodite, Tonto Aphrodite over here in the green room. I'm going to bring her back for just a second, just for a second, so she can take your comments.
Okay, taking your comments. Let's see. We've got Evie Toddy. She's a hottie. So that means that she could host a show like me, too, and get lots of listeners. Viewers, listeners, whatever you want. You can have them both because you are Evie Toddy. Since college, you've been getting the Evie Toddy hottie. If you eat lots of bowls of special kind of ice cream, you could be having gelati. You could be having an Evie Toddy the Hottie gelati. And if you eat too much, then you go to the potty.
All right, I think I overstepped the boundaries there with the potty. I did not need to go potty, but I'll bet you got that. I'll bet you an element. See, in college, you probably got the hottie or the hot toddy. In elementary school, probably a lot of potty. Am I right or am I wrong? Wouldn't it be terrible if she said, oh, geez, I've never made that connection before, Mr. Rude. Oh, we got Pinky crying again. See? Tears. So Pinky and Melanie, I'm sure Melanie went away. The stick rate. We need to work on the stick rate. Some of these people, they pop in, they say hi, and then they're like, I'm out of here. Oh, you weren't born. Oh, she married into the Toddy. Well, no, is that right? If you weren't born with that name. College, were you married in college? Evie, we need to have you on the show. You are so interesting. I've got 1,000 questions for you. We could have Aphrodite interview you, but I'm not ready. Now, of course, if Rob Hicks and crew were broadcasting the show, producing the show, they'd get Evie on here in no time. They'd figure out a way. And then they'd just say, Rob would hold up a sign and says, we've got Evie on the line. And I'd say, are you kidding me? And then later he'd say, you know, you really don't need to say, are you kidding me, on the broadcast, because people don't know what you're talking about. I like to break the fourth wall, folks. I need an animation of a fourth wall breaking because I do it all the time. Just like I did this one. When I go all over the place. I'm sorry, no. All over the map. If you're going to do a one-liner, Bob, get it right. Oh, I see. So wait. Okay, dude, I had to come up with an into college, so I came up with that. Oh, into, and now I say it all the time. Epic. Sometimes I just read comments like Rob just epic. There's no, I don't say I'm reading a comment, although it's right there. So I guess you can see that I'm doing that. Oh, yo, wait a minute. You're Web Evie. Evie, are you kidding me? Of course I remember you. Ladies and gentlemen, now she gets all new applause. Evie Toddy, the hottie with gelati.
Sometimes goes to the potty.
Was like among the first group of people who showed up on my Periscope broadcasts and Joe Simon's broadcasts and things like that. Of course I remember you. See, I even got kisses for the butcher. By the way, any of you are welcome to send me kisses. I don't even discriminate. It's like, I don't care who you are, because I know what you mean. Do I? I don't really think I know what I'm talking about right now. Anyway, can we get back to Tim Cook and what he was saying about VR? You people just distract me constantly. So I'm a big fan of VR, virtual reality, you know. But the thing is with the virtual reality is you put the headset on and that's your world. That's it. It's whatever's computer generated, that's where you live in. Clearly, we're not going to have a planet of people living in headsets, right? However, augmented reality, some call it mixed reality, is a combination of computer generated images and what you really see. Imagine putting on like glasses, these would be them. By the way, Clark Kent, Superman. Clark Kent, unrecognizable. Superman, never make the difference. The difference? Bob, if you're gonna talk, use words. All right. But these, like, listen, these are your augmented reality goggles. So you put them on, you still see the world, but you also see things superimposed on that world. That's the future. because that's the future. VR is going to be fun. It will always be around for some purposes, but for everyday use, it's going to be augmented reality. And Tim Cook, CEO of Apple, the producers of the defective 6 Plus screen, also prefers augmented reality. And to be honest, I didn't even read the article. I just assumed that that's the same, is for the same reason. Because if you're going to do a practical application, you got to be able to see the real world and interact with it. Otherwise, you're just living in an isolated digital cave. The AR feature of Snapchat filters. I know, Botox in a swipe is right. All those, if you haven't seen the episode of The Bob Doyle Show called What's That on Your Face? I don't remember what episode it is, but we do a whole show on all the, it is kind of augmented reality, the face mask type of stuff. Pokemon Go is an example of augmented reality, where I, by the way, still haven't downloaded or ever played Pokemon Go. And my son says that people aren't playing it as much anymore because there's something about the servers. Nintendo shut down the servers that tell you where the Pokemon are because somebody was hacking, somebody somehow hacked it and was telling everybody where they are. And so they shut down, whatever. Anyway, you just have to look into it. Hearts as well. I like hearts. I like hearts. I like and bunnies. I don't know what the bunnies are for. Did I say something about four rabbits? Four rabbits, four bunnies. I'm just seeing if maybe there's a rebus in here. Anyway, so augmented reality. And so the first device that's out there these days that's really going to be like super duper about that is the Microsoft HoloLens, which isn't available, but man, do I want to get my hands on that. Can we talk once again about air travel just real quick? Because look, there's just one other thing I wanted to say. I have a friend, Rachel Reinstra, who has been on this program, did a whole app thing. See, there's so many programs. Yes, four rabbits. But why? Why four rabbits? Why four rabbits, Helen? Autumn is here. Autumn, Web Evie's here. Right above you. If you look right above you, Evie's in the house. Now, I know Evie knows Autumn. Autumn knows Evie, right? We're all from the same Periscope group. Oh, Periscope. Shall I go back to you? I don't know. What do you guys think? What do you think, Autumn and Evie? Is there still a place for Bob Doyle on Periscope? Because every time I go there, there ain't nobody there. Well, for me anyway. Well, it's because I don't do it regularly, said all of you who know. So Rachel has this ongoing thing where whenever she gets on a plane, there's a screaming kid. Yeah, the old scope days. No, don't go. All right, I won't. About babies crying. And we've all been on plane. If you've been on a plane, you've been on a plane with a crying baby. Am I right? Is a garbage pit? Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. In writing, Autumn McGrath reviews Periscope garbage pit now, in quotes. I was not a fan of this page. I don't know how that happened, Jennifer. Look, if any of you are watching this now and you have not liked this page yet, would you please do that? We need that. This page has very little likes. Mostly probably because I never really made a big deal out of telling people to like it. But now that we are doing the show here, have I even started the show yet? We're 49 minutes in. I'm not quite sure I've started yet. But you know how babies cry? Have you ever noticed that? How babies cry? Let me tell you something about the way babies cry. They don't think twice about crying, do they? They've got an emotion. They're uncomfortable. They're the little bit uncomfortable. And they just wail like there is no tomorrow. And even though we don't like it as adults, sometimes we just freaking hate it, right? It's still, quote unquote, acceptable. You know what I mean? It's like, socially, there's no law against it. They're not going to throw the babies in jail. Any of that stuff. They're just expressing their emotions naturally and in the moment. What if it was okay for babies to do that too? Did I just say that? Ugh. What if it was, take two. What if it was okay for humans to do that too? Like, what if you were on the plane and you were sad about something And just, it was okay if you just, the whole flight. What if everyone on the plane was just open about their emotions? Would that be the most disturbing thing ever? Just adults just screaming and crying? Just because it was in them to do it? It's okay for babies to do it. But what if humans could do it? And not just on planes, everywhere. Like, what if it was okay? What if it was normal for humans just to not suppress their emotions at all? And whatever they were feeling anywhere in the world, they just let it out. Like, there was no societal structure around that. And it was just totally okay to just emote. That would just be weird. Although, if the way that it was, it would just be how it is. But man, I'll bet you there'd be a lot of people. I bet you there'd be more people with headphones and earplugs in their ears. What kind of a world would it be if you could just walk down the street and everybody's just being honest with their emotions? Holy crap, that would be weird. Society would be different, but airplanes particularly. They'd have to do something different with airplanes. We'd have to have the cones of silence. You've thought about that? Really? Oh. Well, so much for me being original. Jenny Q is way ahead of me. Like if people could just cry on planes like that. And I know the parents of those kids crying, they want to. It's the most, I mean, I've had small kids on a plane. I don't have a recollection of having the kids be the one who, I mean, maybe a little whimper here and there or crying for a couple of minutes, but you know the babies I'm talking about. Those babies that just don't know when to quit. Yeah, flights, I mean, don't you just wish you could just rationalize with babies? Hey, look, do you need to fart? Is that the problem here? A burp? What's going on? You can't be upset about anything emotionally. You're not developed enough to be sad at the events of the world or that Trump's running for president or any of that stuff. Did I say that out loud? Anyway, so it's got to be a physical discomfort thing. And then there's that whole thing. But you can't rationally, you can't reason with babies. They're so stupid. Babies are so dumb. They just can't form. Use your words, babies. Well, one of these days. You know, they got all these new things. Like there's this thing that's coming out and I can't remember what it's called. But it's the thing you put in your ear and it's supposed to automatically translate languages, you know, like the Babelfish and Hitchhiker's Guide. Anyone, 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 anyone. So if you could have a baby interpreter, you know, like that's the first time anyone's thought of that. Dog interpreter, cat interpreter, animal interpreter, baby interpreter. What would the babies tell you? My stomach hurts so much right now and I don't understand why. Why are my ears about to explode? I'm very confused. Someone help me. Now that's a whole different world than the bratty kids who know damn well what they're doing. You know, 4 years, 3 to 6, in some cases 7 to 8. Those are the ones you really just want to say, here's a parachute, we'll pick you up later. Bend your knees, tuck and roll. Maybe they heard me. They're kids, bones grow back. Anyway, babies, right? Am I right, ladies and gentlemen? We'd be better off without them. They smell too. Am I right, ladies and gentlemen? Babies, loud, they smell. Ugh, ugh. They contribute nothing to society until later. But the odds probably, I mean, you know, of all the babies, some contribute to society, some just glom right off of it. Let's face it, some babies, they become liabilities. Not assets. If there was just a way to tell, right off the bat. That's right. Autumn, you made me laugh. Babies, bunch of jerks. Speaking of kids, I have a question for you. This is sensitive. Shoot, I'm out of time again. I have to do the Apptacular. All right, look, I'm going to say this. And then the show's going to run a little bit long because I'm going to do Apptacular because I haven't done it in like weeks. And it's going to be a little sketchy too because I have to turn off your comments so I can get it ready. So I was at, I'm just going to try and be as vague as possible about this. But I was at someone's house, and I went to their bathroom. Now, if you like that part of the story, just hang on, because there's more. Went to the bathroom, and I didn't even think anything of that. I guess I've seen this for a while. Anyway, you know how people have art in their bathroom, pictures of whatever, plants, who knows? Whatever. People have things in their bathroom. Truly you don't know what I'm talking about? All right. People decorate their walls. Well, in this particular house, these people had a picture of their kids hanging over the toilet. So if you just said somebody, just told somebody, yeah, I got pictures of my kids. And I don't know. But you know, now ladies, you may not relate to this as much as men do, because generally speaking, ladies are facing a different direction than men when they're doing their business on the toddy, gelati, hottie, potty. But as a male, well, you're standing there in a situation that is private and you're looking at kids and they're looking at you. So I'm just wondering, I'm throwing it out there for some social feedback. Pictures of kids over the toilet, was this a well thought out plan? I'm just saying. Just think about it, gentlemen. It's just somebody else's kids and you're... Maybe it's just my own, maybe I have a problem. I've never, never noticed, years I've noticed it, but for whatever reason, this time I did. And I was like, it's not, and I didn't go and say, guys, you should maybe think about this. Because I thought, well, maybe I'm just revealing myself to be a little whacked in the head. But to me, it's like, I just happened to notice they've got the pictures there. They're clearly supposed to be looked at. But when that's the time that they're looked at, is if you're standing there looking. Otherwise, you go in, and you're facing another direction. You never see the picture. So the picture obviously has to be looked at. The only time is when... And this is a graphic representation of, never seen a family portrait in the bathroom. And that's what I started to think about, too. How many homes have I been in where there's pictures of their family in the bathroom? And I just realized that we have that. Not my family. But what happened? You guys went black on me there. All right, well, that's fine because I have to turn this off anyway because I have to go... I have to turn off this because I have to go to my phone because that's where Apptacular is going to be in a minute when I stop talking about going to the bathroom in front of pictures of children. That's right. And I just closed the app that I wanted to show you because that's the way my brain works when I'm flustered. And I'm flustered because I'm talking about really sketchy material right now. All right, now I have to AirPlay and we are going to go to, just give me a second because... I've got multiple devices. Something else you didn't know about me, am I right? Sorry. Wow, where is this show going, ladies and gentlemen? I'll tell you where it's going. It's going to... Apptacular. If I can find it. Ladies and gentlemen, Apptacular is the section of the show where I cut off my head again. Do I have to really squat like this? No, I have to fix this. I'm not doing that. I'm not going to sit like this the whole time. Something is really screwy here. All right, well, anyway, fine. I have to push a button to make the volume go down. Ladies and gentlemen, Apptacular is a segment of the show that we sometimes do where I share with you an app that I think is spectacular. Apptacular. Do you see what I did there? Okay. Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. I had no idea. Totally unnecessary. Just relax. All right, get it out of your system, Ladies and gentlemen, today we are looking at a virtual reality-ish type of app called Cardboard Camera. Cardboard comes from Google Cardboard, which we have discussed many times on this program. If you are not in the know, please go back. I think it's episode 8 or 9 or something, virtually real. Anyway, I go through a lot of virtual reality apps available for your phone, smart or otherwise. No, not otherwise. Got to be smart. Even if the screen doesn't always work properly sometimes. So, You're probably all familiar with, and look, I know I'm late. I should be ending the show. I'm not gonna. How about that? I'm gonna finish this, and then we'll end the show. You're probably well familiar with panoramic pictures, even 360-degree pictures, where, and I've shared them on the show, where you can take a 360-degree panorama picture of your surround. Did I see? That's not. You know what? Here's what's gonna. No, I'm not gonna do it. And then you can put your phone into the Google Cardboard, and as you look around, it's like you're where. Excuse me. The coffee's catching up with me. It's like you're wherever you are, and wherever you look, it scans the picture, pans the picture. Now, here's the thing about those. As cool as they are, and they do work, I've taken plenty of panoramic 360-degree pictures on my phone, looked at them here on Google Cardboard by putting them in my phone, or even in my HTC Vive. And I put my headset on, I'm just really looking around. But here's the thing about those pictures that you take. They're not in stereo. What the hell do you mean, Bob? I mean 3D. They're not 3D. They look around, but there's no depth. Like if there's a, like if I did it right here and the microphone's closer to me, then it's all just flat. You know what I'm saying? It still looks good, but it's not 3D. Now, ladies and gentlemen, with this app here, we have entered the 3D world. Now, of course, this is something that's not going to translate well here because you're not watching this in 3D. I'm not broadcasting it. Well, you are actually in three dimensions. Just so you know, you can go through your day knowing that, good, I'm in three dimensions. And that's the way that goes. No, Autumn, you just got here. What do you mean, gotta run? What is with you people? This is a commitment. All right. What this program does is it works a lot like those panoramic pictures, except it's not 360. It is, you know, I'll show you. You can even see here. See these pictures here? These are pictures I took as a test. I'll give you this one, for example. I'm gonna turn the phone sideways. And now what we've got is basically a long panorama picture that just keeps cycling, okay, as I scroll around. This is my kitchen. So we got the microwave over here, and then as we pan around, that's looking out the window, and then it just goes around in a full circle. So I can keep doing this. But you see this right here? Now, if I click on the little cardboard viewer, it's gonna say, place your phone into your default cardboard viewer. Now what we've got is two different pictures that, because of the brilliance of this app, they're different because, well, I don't know, but this is sincere. So when I put this in my handy dandy Google Cardboard, it would be easier to that. Oops, sorry, I shot the button somehow. Oh, here we go. And I look through here, you can't see. Why is it, what is it looking at there? It's not seeing. What is that a picture of? What the heck is that a picture? Why is my? Why is that in there? Hold on, that's weird. All right, let's. This is the one I want to see. So going in here, there we go. Now, I see around. I think you can see what I'm doing. Now the difference is, you can see. Oh, good. Stephanie Houston and Jay Garrett liked my page, the Bob they did. And it was important for all of you to know it. Meaning, for example, refrigerator, then folks, I know I can't look down. It doesn't record the floor ceiling yet. Look, if you haven't yet invested in a board, you can get super, super, super cheap. I do not like when it's off. Someone back here. All you need is that. If you haven't gotten one of these things, you can get them anywhere between like $2 or $3 if you're willing to fold it up and make it yourself, or $25 all assembled with a little headband and stuff like that. Please go get one of these things. They're super cheap. They work with the phone that you probably got right now. And there's so many cool apps out there that are VR related and panorama related to get you, to give you a sense of what virtual reality is about and really have some super deep experiences. And this little cardboard Google thing, I know it seems like a step backwards because it's not 360 or whatever, but folks, think about this. I got with a camera that it is not stereo. A stereo camera has two lenses, one for each eye. This one did this with one lens because of the way that it's working. I could get into how it works because I do know, but I'm not going to tell you because you'd be bored silly. And I can't have that. I own 4 kitchens, yes. That'd be nice. Anyway, go get that and go download every VR app you can possibly and join me back. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching The Bob Doyle Show, just as it says right here on this fancy graphic that says Bob Doyle Show on it. I am, of course, Bob Doyle. And that's right, ladies and gentlemen. The Bob Doyle Show is now coming to an end for this week. We are here every Friday at noon Pacific and Wednesdays at noon Pacific at Bob Doyle at facebook.com/Bob Doyle LA for Law of Attraction related broadcast. We will see you whenever you decide to join us again. It has been my pleasure, as always, to be a part of your day.